Hello everyone, my name is Francesco Cipollone. I'm the CEO and co-founder of Phoenix Security. I never thought I would record two videos in a row of the same vulnerability, but there is an update on the exploitation. We've seen today a massive exploitation in what is now called React4Shell or React2Shell. Let's review what has changed today in this vulnerability exploitation. So we published a previous article with full detail of the timeline, the exploitation, the anatomy, the version affected. So I'm not going to go in deep into the various version affected. I want to focus today on the new exploitation, the timeline, the various report, because this exploitation is moving very fast and there is new continuously. So let's start from a timeline and let's start from the name. These are CVE-2025-55182 and then there is a 66478 for Next.js. Those two vulnerabilities together have been named React4Shell or React2Shell because affect Node and React. That is fundamentally what powers the entirety of the web from a web server perspective. And the web server perspective, if you don't understand or don't know how the infrastructure is created, is fundamentally the system that provides every user's the information reply to you, like the website, and is the first one that responds. So this particular vulnerability is malicious because first of all can be triggered remotely with a simple string or with a simple payload. We're not going to go in depth on the payload, and that will make the system crash and give you a shell back. And if you're an attacker, you can do all malicious things with that shell. Now, what has changed from yesterday? And if you see the video yesterday, I mentioned the fact that there wasn't an active exploitation, but there were a number of proof of concept repositories across 70 to 100. We have a change between which one is publishing with which name, but roughly 70 to 100. Now, what has changed is yesterday night, Fastly has seen increased attack and exploitation on this particular vulnerability. And Fastly is a provider that is fairly distributed. We've seen some more disruption on Cloudflare today, this morning, 5th of December, Friday, around 9 a.m. GMT, 8 a.m. GMT. Now, there seems to be just upgrade or a wrong patch on this system, but we don't know because a lot of these servers are web-powered. Now, what also has changed is the fact that threat actor, Chinese threat actor have been, state-sponsored threat actor have been associated with this particular exploit and a larger exploitation than normally. So if we look at the timeline of this vulnerability, on the 29th of November, this vulnerability got exploited and reported by through the bug bounty of Meta open source that is currently the one that maintain all of the React and Next vulnerability libraries. And then on the 3rd, there been the disclosure with these two new CVE. Now on the 4th, so a day after this vulnerability, there been an increased number of exploitation. So between the 3rd and the 4th at night, one day, there been an increased number of exploitation of these vulnerabilities. And if we look at the Fastly reports, around 4 p.m., around the 4th and 9 p.m., 8 p.m. GMT, there's been an increased amount of exploitation that then has been then confirmed by it being associated to Chinese threat actor and sponsored threat actor through their monitoring of the Honeynet. Now, why this particular vulnerability is bad and why it is easy to be exploited, we're not going to show the full detail around the vulnerability and the exploitation, but just to show a case of a number of POC being coded or vibe coded, it's fairly easy to exploit this particular vulnerability. You launch the POC or any of the POC, it gives you the shells, and then you can see that you get etc password that is one of the protected systems or one of the protected folder in a system that usually requires access to an elevated privileged system, and it gives you the shell. That's hence why the name React2Shell. Now, This particular vulnerability is bad. There's been a number of systems being affected. There are rules that you can deploy using your WAF or your Google Cloud Armor, depending on which system you are. And the version affected are currently React, Node, Next.js, React and Next.js. There are 19 and 19.1. Now, the thing that you need to be aware of, if you are on a pin version, like you can see here, it won't update automatically. For Shai Halud that you're gonna see in the link in the description, there will be a number of pin version that was recommended and not auto-update. In this particular case, this will be suggested to auto-update or go to the next version. So by changing the version of the system and rebuilding it, despite if this is a container or not a container, you'll be able to do it. Timeline-wise, again, it's been very fast-paced. There are a number of web vulnerabilities that are affected and a number of systems that have been affected by this vulnerability. Recommendation is deploy the WAF rule. You can see them in here, or and start patching. Now, with Phoenix Security, you can review your vulnerability affected by a particular campaign. We have the campaign that you can directly download from the website. You can monitor your SPOM libraries and the library that are affected, in this particular, the webpack, for example. And you can monitor systems if they are upgradable. Now, if a system or a library that is built in a particular set of container that are externally facing, that's my simple web system or external facing, this library will have an increased vulnerability. Now, because this is a pure 10 or a highest criticality that you can have, this will be decreased only if any of these system or the system are more internally facing. So we will mitigate the vulnerability if a system is internally facing. Review the vulnerability. The exploit is fairly easy. There are a number of POC out there, and review the previous detail description of the vulnerability if you want to see a little bit more detail about how many versions are affected, which version is affected the most, and how to go about this new timeline and exploitation. The vulnerability has been exploited by a number of threat actors. It's super easy to deploy the exploit, as you've seen. So out there, patch system, start from external, deploy your WAF rule, go in internally, upgrade your system, and stay safe out there. Goodbye.